Yakut Corporation and Yakovlev Design Bureau present the Yak-130 Combat Trainer Jet, the ultimate key to the sky. The Yak-130 is the core element of an integrated training system ensuring effective training of fighter pilots at all stages, including selection and technical studies, primary, basic, and advanced flight training, development of situational awareness and tactical out-of-cabin thinking, decision-making in time-critical situations, as well as combat employment of various weaponry. While piloting the Yak-130 in various flight modes, the cadet pilot practices takeoff and landing, masters standard and advanced maneuvering, acquires skills of flight in pair and unit formation, exercises nighttime piloting, instrument flight, and navigation in common and adverse weather conditions, as well as practices in-flight refueling if a refueling probe is installed on the aircraft. The Yak-130 is an effective platform to train pilots in dogfighting. This is achieved due to its excellent maneuverability, high thrust-to-weight ratio, superb speed, acceleration, and altitude characteristics. While flying the Yak-130 in a near-real combat environment, the cadet pilots acquire experience in the live employment of various weaponry. In total, on the Yak-130, cadet pilots execute up to 80% of a fighter pilot's training program, which allows them to master the most advanced combat aircraft within the shortest time span. The Yak-130 has set a brilliant example to other jets in its class by demonstrating a performance similar to that of modern and prospective fighters.
Стал эталоном для машин своего класса во всем мире. При этом стоимость одного лётного
часа. Its flight hour costs 4 to 6 times less in comparison with the fourth generation twin-seat combat training fighter.
Четвёртого поколения.
The Yak-130 Combat Trainer is a monoplane of classic aerodynamic configuration with a swept mid-wing, wing-tooth extensions, well-developed high-lift devices, and subsonic air intakes provide stable and controllable flight at angles of attack of up to 35 degrees. The two latest design bypass turbojet engines total 5 tons of thrust to provide the high thrust-to-weight ratio of the aircraft. The engines are renowned for high reliability, simplicity of maintenance, low specific fuel consumption, low noise, and low smoke emissions. The fuselage is made of high-strength aluminum-magnesium-lithium alloys, featuring no composite power elements, which simplifies the airframe and meets requirements for easy and low-cost maintenance and repairability. The aircraft features a four-fold redundant fly-by-wire system. It ensures designated stability and controllability parameters, and provides automatic restriction of maximum angle of attack and G-load. The Yak-130 cockpit's design is identical to that of the prospective fighters. All necessary data is presented to pilots on 3 large-scale, multifunctional color displays in each cockpit, and on a head-up display in the front cockpit. Aircraft and engine controls implement the hands-on throttle and stick concept. The aircraft is self-sufficient in operation and does not require any particular infrastructure. The independent engine startup, powering of onboard equipment without ground power supply, as well as cockpit air conditioning on the ground, are ensured by the Yak-130 auxiliary power plant. The onboard oxygen generation station also contributes to the high degree of operational autonomy. To prevent damage to the engine by foreign objects, air intakes are screened with doors during takeoff and landing. The Yak 130 can operate even from unpaved airfields due to nose landing gear with a mudguard and lever-type main landing gear with low-pressure tires. In an emergency situation, the crew is safely ejected by the escape system. The canopy glass is fragmented by pyrotechnic cords. Ejection seats enable crew to leave the aircraft at the full range of speeds and within the entire altitude envelope of the aircraft. Besides crew training, the Yak 130 can be employed as a lightweight attack aircraft in low-intensity conflicts. It is able to carry up to 3 tons of various munitions at 9 hardpoints, 6 underwing, 2 wingtip, and 1 underfuselage. Hardpoints can accommodate air-to-air and air-to-ground missiles, rockets, guns and bombs, target designation and countermeasures pods, as well as auxiliary fuel tanks. While employed as a combat aircraft, the Yak 130 can perform air patrol missions and engagement of low-speed aerial targets. Destruction of point ground and maritime targets. The ultimate proof of the Yak 130's excellent performance is its acquisition by the Russian Air Force. The Yak 130 is the key to your skies.
Operation presents Yakovlev 130. Generation fighter pilot training, high operational autonomy and enhanced flight safety, 3,000 kilograms payload at 9 hardpoints, simulation of combat employment on terrain and airborne targets, employment as a light attack aircraft. In-flight refueling training. Flight Hour Coast. Low Aircraft Life Cycle Coast.
We're glad we're finally back to supersonic age.
Hey, quiet. 来不及换镜头啊，这个镜头太大了。
也要推荐我要拍台比较做的比较好一点，三下镜面真的很震撼。
performance of supersonic fighter. State-of-the-art avionics. Multi-role. Now, your air becomes much stronger. Fighting Eagle FA-50. T-50 Golden Eagle, the optimal advanced jet trainer to train 21st century fighter pilots. Based on T-50, KAI has developed aerobatic T-50B and lead-in fighter trainer TA-50. FA-50 is a powerful multi-purpose combat aircraft born from extending the tactic capability of TA-50. FA-50 has maximum power of 17,700 pounds and maximum takeoff weight of 27,300 pounds with its GEF-404-102 engine and its full length of 43.1 feet, full width 31 feet, full height 15.9 feet, and wing area 255 square feet. FA-50, based on T-50, is capable of loading armament and radar to enhance the combat capability. And it's an advanced jet trainer optimized for training the next generation fighter pilots. Capable of simultaneous tracking of two targets and has wide detection area with its high resolution map application. And it also has excellent air-to-ground attack capability. It has excellent viability with installed radar warning receiver and countermeasures dispenser system that are applied to the cutting-edge fighter. By sharing a real-time battlefield information with air and army forces with its tactics data link capability, close joint operation capability, and mission success rate are very high. With its night vision equipment, it enhanced night tactics attack mission capability. It has precise and threatening offense power to burn enemy aircraft and to camp to the ground with the basic weapons such as air-to-air, air-to-ground missile, and automatic cannon, but also with the precise guide missile such as joint direct attack munition. FA-50, a strong fighter and state-of-the-art trainer, will guard your air solidly.
더 높고 푸른 창공에 우리의 꿈이 날고 있습니다. 현실로 이룬 카이의 꿈이 힘차게 비상합니다. 카이가 만들어가는 새로운 하늘, 또 다른 미래, 가슴벅찬 새로운 감동을 카이가 준비합니다. 첨단 기술과 경제적, 기술적 파급 효과로 인해 국가 경쟁력을 좌우하는 성장 동력으로 부상하고 있는 항공우주 산업. 항공우주 산업의 중심에 카이가 있습니다. 항공기의 설계에서부터 최종 조립에 이르기까지 대한민국 유일의 항공기 체계 종합 전문 기업 카이. 독자 모델 항공기로 개발된 기본 훈련기 KT-1은 공군의 전투기 조종사 양성 임무를 성공적으로 수행하며 항공기의 수출 시대를 열어가고 있습니다. 세계 최고 성능을 지닌 초음속 구동 훈련기 T-50 골든 이글은 탁월한 기술 경쟁력을 갖추고 있어 지속적으로 수요 증가와 함께 21세기 세계시장 선점을 기대하고 있습니다. 이외에 공군의 주력 전투기인 KF-16 전투기와 국내 독자 개발한 무인 항공기 사업을 성공적으로 수행하였습니다. 한반도 지형에 적합한 육군의 차세대 헬기 개발 사업, 군용 민수용 헬기를 포함한 항공기의 수명 연장과 성능 개량 사업을 수행하고 있습니다. 그리고 대형 민항기의 기체 구조물과 F-15K, 아파치 헬리콥터의 동체 등을 생산하여 납품하고 있습니다. 민항기 국제 공동 개발 사업과 미성 사업, 방산전자 사업에도 참여하고 있습니다. 차근차근 준비하고 하나하나 이루어가는 꿈을 향한 카이의 열정. 더 멀리, 더 높이, 세계로, 미래로. 카이가 더 큰 꿈을 펼쳐갑니다. 항공우주 분야의 독자 개발 능력을 확보하고 국제 경쟁력을 높이기 위한 카이의 끊임없는 노력. 세계 초우량 항공우주 기업을 향한 카이의 변화는 이미 시작되었습니다. 카이는 설계에서부터 시험평가에 이르는 항공기 개발의 모든 과정을 독자적으로 수행할 수 있는 지금의 능력에 만족하지 않고 카이의 기술로 만든 세계 최고 성능의 항공기가 지구촌의 모든 하늘을 비상하는 큰 꿈을 이루기 위해 도전과 혁신을 멈추지 않습니다. 2010년 세계 10위권 항공우주 기업으로 성장하여 마침내 우리의 기술로 한국형 전투기 개발을 실현할 카이. 카이는 꿈을 현실로 이룰 큰 힘을 가지고 있습니다. 카이가 세계 항공산업의 중심이 됩니다. 상공을 향한 인간의 꿈을 실현하고 인류의 미래를 보다 풍요롭게 만들어갈 그 이름. 세상을 바꾸고 미래를 바꿀 꿈의 기술을 카이가 만들어갑니다.
Griswold with Lockheed Martin Aeronautics. I'm here at the Dubai Air Show representing the T-50 Advanced Jet Trainer. There's a lot of interest in the region for new trainers, particularly with the introduction of advanced fourth generation aircraft and also the possibility of fifth generation aircraft being flown by regional air forces. They need a new trainer in order to adequately prepare their pilots for those advanced aircraft. What the T-50 brings is the ability to train both the very low end of the pilots that are just coming into the advanced jet trainer, as well as to be able to prepare them adequately for the high-performance jet aircraft. The T-50 aircraft today is configured to look very close to an F-16. As F-35s start becoming more predominant in air forces, we have the ability to adapt the T-50 to more closely mimic the cockpit of an F-35 for the true fifth-generation training.
T-50 was developed in cooperation with Lockheed Martin, and currently we're trying to sell this aircraft to the international customers. It can reach Mach 1.5, it has great avionics, state-of-the-art fuselage design. Our final goal is to capture the US Air Force's T-X program.
T-50 같은 경우는 상당히 많은 항전 장비들, 그리고 국산 항공기라 그런지 또 만지는 내 자부심이 느껴지는 그런 부분이 있습니다. 대한민국 누구나한테 물어봐도 그런 대답이 나올 거라서
I'm really good to be here in the UK and hope that everyone can enjoy the show.
I'm Mike Griswold with Lockheed Martin Aeronautics, and we're here at the Singapore Air Show, which is the largest air show in Asia, representing the T-50 aircraft, multi-role trainer. We're partnered with Korean Aerospace, a longtime industry partner of Lockheed Martin. We co-developed the T-50 aircraft explicitly to perform the role that we're now representing for advanced jet training. The Korean Air Force has fully integrated the T-50 into their training program, replacing the T-38s that they used previously. In addition, showing the versatility of the T-50 platform, they're incorporating it into a light combat role within the Korean Air Force. Again, it exemplifies the versatility of the T-50 platform. The Korean Air Force uses the T-50 as their aerial demonstration aircraft in an outstanding program, which they call the Black Eagles. The Black Eagles are performing here at the Singapore Air Show and clearly are the star of the show. There's a lot of demand for new trainers in the world today as the training requirements are elevated with fifth-gen aircraft coming online. T-50 has already had good success in the market with a recently completed program with Indonesia and a new program that was just announced selling T-50 trainer aircraft to Iraq. Now, I think we're so excited at Lockheed to be working with Korean Aerospace on T-50. We think it's the right trainer for the U.S. Air Force market as well as air forces around the world.
To export 12 FA-50 fighter jets to the Philippines for $420 million. The FA-50, a variant of the T-50 Golden Eagle supersonic trainer, is built by Korea Aerospace Industries. Under the terms of the government-to-government deal, KAI will deliver the jets to Manila in the next 38 months. It follows similar contracts with Iraq last year and Indonesia in 2011. KAI also has its sights set on selling the FA-50 to Peru, Botswana, and the United Arab Emirates. The contract comes after President Pakanay and Philippine President Benigno Aquino signed a memorandum of understanding on expanding the defense cooperation back in October.